So once you find all the intersection points in the top view because of the section plane, then connect this point by continuous thick line. Okay. So this 1 and 2, which is on the edge O1 and O2. Then connect 2 and 4. Observe this image. That is 3D image. Then you can understand. Then 4 and 6. 6 and 5 directly. Then 5 and 3. And 3 and 1. Okay. So this is the top view for this section. Now connect this O3 by continuous thick line, then O4. So the geometry, which is shown by the white line, it is to be written, okay? And therefore, when you draw the second view, that is the second stage top view and front view, first draw this by thin lines, okay? And then use the continuous thick line. So this is the actual top view, okay? And do not show these hidden lines. Just remove this hidden line. Okay, so this is your complete sectional top view. Now just highlight this sectional section by using hatching line. Okay, so this is your complete sectional top view. So you can observe here in a 3D software. So this is your sectional front view in the second stage. And this is the sectional top view. Now draw the x1, y1 line to draw the sectional side view. Now first complete the side view without considering the section line. Okay, just consider the complete solid and draw the side view. So in this side view, find out the intersection points by observing front view and top view. So this is point O, that is apex. Then this is point 1 and 2. You can observe here. So this is the projector from point 1. This is projector from point 2. And this is the intersection for the projector 1 and 2. Okay. Similarly, observe the point 6 and 3. So this is 6. So this is point 6. This is point 3. Then for the base edge, which is resting on the HP, it is 5 and 4. So this is point 5. This is point 4. So now connect all these points by a straight line. So these are the visible lines in the side view. Now the hidden lines which are in the side view, they are O5, then O4. Okay, so only two lines are hidden in the side view. So this is just a side view without considering this section. Now we have to project the intersection points because of the sectional plane. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So take the projector. Okay, so here this is the projector from point 1 and this is the projector from point 2. Okay, now take the projector from point 1 and 2 from the front view. So you can locate this point 1 and 2. So this is point 1, which is on the edge O1. On edge slant edge O2, we have the second point. So you can name those points. Okay, so next take the projection from point 3 and 4. So 3 is on the slant edge O6 and 4 it is on the slant edge O3. So this is point 3 and this is point 6, sorry, this is point 4. And last is point 5 and 6. So you can observe here, this is the point 5, which is on the base edge 6-5, and this is the point 6, which is on the edge 3-4. Okay. Now connect this point 1, 2, 4, 6, 5 and 1. So this is the sectional side view. Okay. So now you can observe the complete sectional side view. Now this portion, it is the actual section. So we will show this by section line. And just remove this dotted lines. So this is your complete sectional side view, okay? And then observe from the perpendicular direction and complete the true shape of the section. So true shape of the section, it is similar to the sectional side view. So try to complete the true shape. So today we will stop here.